Good morning, guys, from this beautiful day on Koh Phangan. It's bloody hot. I'm already sweating and it's the first minute in today's video, guys. We are going to talk about Bitcoin, of course, smashing the 9,300, and hopefully it will close this 9,300 candle at the end of this week. We are going to talk about the short-term vision. We are going to talk about the long-term vision. We are going to talk about Grayscale, that is buying up 1.5 times the amount of Bitcoins that are being mined. What does this show us for the future? We are going to talk about China, where you can now inherit Bitcoins, and talk about Trump again supporting these decentralized ways of social media. Also talking about ETN, one of the tokens I bought during my ICO. They keep popping up in the news again, and I will tell you why. And we will end the video by talking about Samsung, because they are now going to work together with Gemini Exchange from the Winklevoss twins. Guys, it's going to be a really cool episode. Start watching it now, and please enjoy it. Good morning, guys. Welcome to my office here on Chalaklan Beach. Let's jump into my office, guys. Good morning, guys. Just running because my t-shirt tells me to run BTC. Bitcoin is running. I am running. Start to watch this beautiful show today about Bitcoin, life, and many other things. Talking about t-shirts, I will add like 5 new t-shirts to our shop today. They will be really, really cool t-shirts. You need to check these out. The link is below the video. Everybody wants to have these t-shirts, I know for sure. I will keep the price as low as possible, guys, so that everybody can order them. And you know, 25% goes to charity. So while you're buying a beautiful t-shirt supporting Bitcoin and blockchain, you also support charities all around the world. I will already say thank you for ordering, but of course it's not obligatory to order t-shirts when you watch my video. Yesterday I had a beautiful interview on Dutch national radio, which was really cool. It was the BNR show. It called CryptoCast, with Madelon Vos and Herbert Blankenstein, two big veterans in the crypto space when it comes to mass media in the Netherlands. I want to thank them for the radio show. It was really cool. It was a 1-hour show in Dutch, so sadly most of my viewers can't listen it or learn some Dutch. Then you go and listen it. I will put the link below the video as well. It was a cool show about Bitcoin, life, travels, blockchain, the future, and many other things. So make sure, if you're Dutch, you watch it. It is bloody hot. The sun is really burning. It is, wow, I think it's the hottest day till now I've seen in Thailand. It rained all night. It was really raining and storming, and the beaches are still wet, but the sun now is so warm. Wow. Talking about the price, guys. Yes, you already heard by me saying it. 9,300 is the level we need to keep our eye on. We want to close this weekly and monthly Bitcoin candle above 9,360 preferable. That would be a very positive sign, because we haven't been able to close these candles above this level for the last months. So if we are able to close this candle now above this resistance level of the last 12 months, then if you look at the big time frames, the monthly charts, this is hugely positive, because then we open a new monthly candle above this resistance line, and then probably this resistance line of 9,360 will become for the support line for the next months to come. So we can go up from there to 10 and then fall back to this support line of 9,300 every time till we build up for this beautiful new bull run. So if you zoom out in crypto and in Bitcoin, this is a huge, huge, exciting moment to come, because, you know, we are just up front this new bull run, and these moments of closure of these candles in the monthly time frame, weekly time frame, these are just very important to see what kind of trajectory we will see in Bitcoin the next couple of months, year. Huge moment this upcoming Sunday. We need to close above this 9,300. If we close above, guys, I'm even getting more bullish than I'm already were. So that's very bullish. If you want to look at the short term, we need to zoom in. Let's zoom in to this beautiful, colorful 4-hour chart that was drawn by Lisa again. if you look at this chart, you can see this Elliott wave we have been talking about a few times. To give you a little bit of education in Elliott wave, if you enter this Elliott wave from the bottom and you go up, then you come down A, B, C, D, E, mostly explode upwards. And if you enter this Elliott wave, this triangle from the top, you come down and then you get A, B, C, D, E, you mostly break out this triangle downwards. So if you take this technical tool and compare this one to the 4-hour chart of Bitcoin, we can see now that we are in wave D, which would mean that D would go all the way up to 9,600, and then we could fall back all the way down to 9,000-ish. But then we fall down to 9,000-ish to break out upwards. So that will be the final push to try and break 10K again. It is not easy to read all these charts, but you will get better at it every time you see my videos. And I will try to explain it in the most simple way. So look at the chart again. We enter from the bottom, we went a little bit up, then we formed the A, B, C, D, E. And then from this E point, we should go and lift off, break 10,500. That would be the best point. But now, very short term, we could go to 9,600 and go back to 9,000. So again, if we go back to 9,000, don't freak out, zoom out, and understand that we could be playing out this Elliott wave that will give us this last push up to 10,500. Why do I think we could easily do this stuff? Because at the moment, if you look at Bitcoin, and I look at it maybe at a different way than other people, but I want to show you how I look at it, you can see how many Bitcoins are mined daily. And if you see and know how many Bitcoins there are mined, you also know how many Bitcoins there can be sold. And if you also know how many people hodl their Bitcoins, like I said in one of my previous videos yesterday, that 60% of the Bitcoin wallet addresses hasn't moved for 12 months. So these 60% of people are hodling their Bitcoins, not selling their Bitcoins. Daily, like 900 Bitcoins are being mined. Then you get this game of supply and demand. But what if you also see at the same time that this huge institutional investor Grayscale is buying up all the Bitcoins that are being mined and even more? Then it gets really exciting. Why? You have a fixed amount of Bitcoins. 60% of the Bitcoins that are out there are not being moved, not being touched. People are hodling them. So only 40% of the Bitcoins out there can be sold, on top of the Bitcoins that are being mined daily. But the Bitcoins that are being mined daily are already bought up by only one company, Grayscale. To be clear, they are buying 1.5 times the amount of Bitcoins that are being mined. That's a shitload of Bitcoins. But if they are buying up all these Bitcoins, how can other people then buy their Bitcoins? That's the biggest question. Because then there will be not that many Bitcoins left for the rest of the world to buy. And what do you think that this will do to the price of Bitcoin? Do you think that will make the price crash? Or do you think when the supply decreases, the price will increase? You know, this is the game of supply and demand. The demand is increasing, the supply is decreasing. The only thing that can happen, in my opinion, if you think logically, is that the price will go up. And then the price needs to go that high that the Bitcoin hodlers, me, you guys out there, are prepared to sell their Bitcoins to make profits. So all these indicators tell me that we are slowly going up. Because when this FOMO happened in 2017, it was a retail investor FOMO. It was the FOMO between you and me, the small people around the world that were freaking out and didn't want to miss out on this Bitcoin bull run. FOMO means fear of missing out. When this FOMO will hit the institutional investors, because one of the bigger institutional investors is topping up their funds hugely with Bitcoins and buying up 1.5 times the amount of Bitcoins around, they are creating FOMO among all the other institutional investors. Because these institutional investors are the same like us. They are just people, you know? They shit on the same toilets. And they are going to freak out because they also don't want to miss this huge bull run. They don't want to miss the Bitcoin boat. No, I said that wrong. They don't want to miss this Bitcoin rocket to the moon. So there will be FOMO among these institutional investors. They will start to buy as well. And then, you know, you get a situation where all the Bitcoins that are available to buy are being bought up and more and more and more, and it will drive the price up, in my opinion. Yes, short term, or we can see this waves going up, whatever wave, Elliott wave, I don't care which wave, surfing wave, I don't care. You can see these waves, but this is the short time. And this is what I want to teach you. Zoom out, look at the bigger time frames, play it long term. If you want to spend your money at the moment, don't spend it at a luxury house, don't spend it at a luxury watch, don't spend it at a second car, don't spend it at all these things that will decrease in value or will not increase as value as much as Bitcoin can do at the moment. I am not a financial advisor, I am not giving investment advice, but I can say to you guys that I see this Bitcoin as something very positive and a very positive opportunity to just increase your capital while you take care of your own capital and keep it in a safe place where nobody else can touch it, can confiscate it from you, where nobody can freeze your money, where nobody can ask you, why do you want to send 10,000? This is also the reason to be in Bitcoin. Protect your capital. This is why all the people in these countries, in Venezuela, in Zimbabwe, in Africa, are now hedging their capital into Bitcoin because of the devaluation of their physical money. The fiat system is slowly collapsing. We can see this. So protect your capital. And then I think at the moment, yes, gold is also a protection. Yes, silver is also a protection. But Bitcoin is probably the best bet at the moment if you look at the past results, because Bitcoin has been the best performing asset in the last 10 years. There has not been one asset that outperformed Bitcoin in these last 10 years. And it's not going to be an asset that's going to outperform Bitcoin in the next couple of years. So I would be, if I would just want to advise you guys to be wise, look at Bitcoin and maybe even try to own one Bitcoin. One Bitcoin. Thank you. I am talking too long, I'm turning around again because I don't want to walk home. So I will keep the next few items a little bit shorter, because I would love you guys to drink one cup of coffee during my video, but I don't want to force you to drinking like 6 cups of coffee during my video, having breakfast and traveling to your work, because then my video will be really too long. China already declared Bitcoin as an official asset, and now not only this, China also made it possible for people in China to inherit Bitcoins. So because Bitcoin became an official asset, these people will be able to inherit Bitcoins, but also any other digital asset, which is really cool because that will solve a lot of problems in the future when I die, when I'm 260 years old and I want to leave my Bitcoins to my children. Then this now is settled in China, and China is leading here, and probably all other countries will do the same thing in the future. I'm still searching for a blockchain project that does this automatically. When you die, all your Bitcoin wallets and everything will automatically be like opened up to your family and friends that then will receive your private keys, etc. Probably there is already one. I think I spoke to one in Switzerland like a year and a half ago. I need to read up to that. So my knowledge is not up to date. I need to check it, and I will come back to this in another video, of course. Trump starts to hugely support us, guys, against these shadow bans and against this censorship in social media. He wants to make a law now that also in online media, social media, you cannot start to shadow ban people or even censorship people, because that is against the freedom of expression. And he is saying, we have been in a country where freedom of expression is a human right, and we are not going to have a few big social media companies handpicking the post that they want to show people and that they don't want to show people. Our American people should be able to see everything that everybody posts. Thumbs up to Trump if it comes to expression of feeling, because also in crypto we have seen that these shadow bans and all these strikes in YouTube, Twitter, Facebook and all over the place are affecting our industry, because we need to be able to say to our followers what we want to say, because that's very important, because it's a huge message. We are in the middle of a technical evolution, of a monetary revolution. We need to have freedom of speech, freedom of expression, and these centralized social media platforms should support us. And if not, we really need to find a way to the decentralized platforms. But that is another subject I already talked about in many other videos. Two more articles I read, you guys. Electronium ETN. This is one of the currencies I invested in during the ICO phase. But Electronium is still alive. I even didn't know they still existed because I didn't hear about them anymore. But today in Cointelegraph, I read this beautiful article about Electronium now making it possible for a people of a few African countries to top up their electricity bill and pay it there. So that is really cool. If they own this Electronium app now, they can pay their electricity bill in Africa with ETN tokens. I think another form of a huge mass adoption. And yes, Africa will be one of the biggest markets, like I said in my video yesterday, because these people really need the power of blockchain and Bitcoin, because their monies are not only devaluating, but they also don't have access to the traditional monetary banking systems. And now they get access to these beautiful digital peer-to-peer cash systems that they can start to use and freely connect to the monetary system. Because Electronium at the same time launched this beautiful project. It's called AnyTask, anytask.com. No, I'm not getting paid for this. I'm just seeing this and I find it very cool that the guys are doing this. AnyTask.com is this marketplace to, you know, sell your skills like Fiverr or like work abroad, all these platforms where you can post jobs and where you can buy jobs. And this AnyTask is also accepting ETN tokens, so peer-to-peer digital cash. So this means that people in Africa that don't have a bank account can still do jobs and be paid in an Electronium in a peer-to-peer cash, and they only need a telephone for this and no bank account. Huge thumbs up for ETN, Electronium over there. Yes, hopefully the price will go up, because that was the thing that made many people sad in the past, because they saw this huge drop in price of Electronium. But Electronium is one of the ICOs that is again proving that it's not all about the price. It's also about creating mass adoption, creating a project that people all over the world can use. So I cannot be negative at this moment about Electronium, because people can now get paid in cryptocurrency and start to spend it also in these beautiful countries. Thumbs up for Electronium. It's really hot because it's almost difficult to breathe, and I keep talking. I am getting a dry mouth, and I'm not going to drink the sea behind me. No, this is too salty for me, guys, sorry. But the last news I'm going to share with you guys is that Samsung now is going to work together with the Gemini exchange. You know this one. Gemini is the Winklevoss brothers exchange. Samsung already announced that they are going to integrate cryptocurrency wallets in their new blockchain supported phones. But now at the same time, they are also going to add the Gemini exchange. Huge thumbs up, of course, for Samsung taking the lead over there, because Samsung has a lot of users. More and more people get familiar with these new kinds of assets we call peer-to-peer cash, cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. Guys, I need to walk into the water because my feet are burning, my face is burning, I need to cool off. While I do this, guys, I want to mention one more big news. We broke the 4K resistance in followers on YouTube. We have now officially 4,010 followers, and this is a huge point for our channel, because we almost grew now in a month's time from 2,000 followers to 4,000 followers just by making these daily videos. Thank you for all your support and thank you for sharing this message with your friends and family. And please continue to share our channel with your friends and family, because my next goal is 10K followers. I don't want to go for the 5K. I'm going to disrupt the 5K, 6K, 7K, 8K, 9K. I'm going to break them all because I want to be at 10K followers as soon as possible. So maybe you can help me with this. But you can start very easy by giving this video against a thumbs up, by subscribing to our channel, by even hitting this bell button so you'll be notified on every new video. And please leave comments, because I love to answer your comments. And please, in these comments, tell me what you want me to talk about in the future, because that is what I want to do. I want to educate you about the things you want to learn. I wish you an amazing day. Like I always end my videos, guys, please zoom out in Bitcoin, zoom in life, enjoy life to the fullest every single minute of the day. That will make life a very beautiful thing to live. Thank you again and see you tomorrow again. Bye.